is 120 high, the character is 120 high. So if I, hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, sir. Transform, translate, and I'm just going to move it down half of that 120, 60 thousandths. There we go. Sorry, that was a little tougher than it should have been, but that's what we wanted right there at that point. We wanted right there at the 12 o'clock position, right in the center of that line, 750 away from the tip of the part.
I missed where the number, where you get the number from.
Yeah. Let me click on save. So when you're ready to draw the number, you go to wireframe, create letter.
I see.
At this point, what I would do is I would create all the numbers along this line. For example, just for simplicity, I'll just duplicate this zero here, for example. So I'm making it 0.2, and I'll have let me just do the real thing here, that'll be easier. So I'm gonna create the number one. What we got? What's the next number? Five. Next number is five. And check my levels. Now, on this one, I'm actually going to choose a different level. I'm going to go the next level up for number 9. Because I want it separate from the zero when I create it. And then just wireframe, create line, create number. With number 5, it's going to be 120. And I'll come in here, like I did before, and make sure I click right. Here at this intersection point, there's my number 5. Click OK. Now I'm going to turn off the 0, that way I can capture this here, and I'm going to move it down. Transform, translate, move. -6. So now it's in position. And there's probably an easier way to do this, but what we'll do is we'll just create each number like this, and then that's right. Sometimes it flips around on you. Let's go to planes. I want to look at the end of it, like this. Where's my 5 at? Right there. Highlight my 5 and transform, rotate 72, green check. No, I should have moved it instead of copying it. Back to my level. Great. And next one. Notice how far apart these are. That was this spacing here, so let's change that. Yeah, 0.03 looks pretty good. Try that.
Or he.
Missed my target again. Third time's a charm, right?
Like that, and then got rid of the 0, put a 5 in the same place, and then moved it to one
like that. After I write the number, remember you have to translate it down.
Because he bases it off of that line.
Does he drop it down?
No, up. Because you got to think you turn the thumbnail this way.
Actually create all the numbers first and then go and do all the rotations. I'm just doing a couple here just to actually do 2 more. We'll go ahead and make a couple more. 11. Number, move it down half the height. Levels, another level.
So you
this like this. I want to rotate this number. So I've got, if you look at my levels here, I've got a different level for 0, 5, 10, 15, and 20. So I had to keep them separate so I could draw a box around them and select them all. And if we look at, if we clean this picture up a little bit, arc, wire.
What was your angle again?
72.
72.
Increments of 72. Let's see if we've got all that again.
I got it.
So now, create a tool path. Back over in this position here, we're going to pick a plane, let's go back to our DZ plane, and let's go to levels and isolate everything that we want to engrave, so just the numbers. Alright, and make sure the plane's proper, go to tool paths. This is going to be another C-axis contour. I'm just going to just try and just turn C-axis contour window. I'm just going to window all the numbers, ask for a start point. I'll just come over here and click on the zero somewhere. Click OK. Cut parameters, that's just off. Linking parameters were 5,000ths in. The rotary control, though, what are they? At the point of where we're engraving, it's a different diameter now, isn't it? Where did it go? 1265. And green check. And back button. And this is how it looks when we run. I'm going to select this one. I'll select the profile, verify.
Figure out what machine you've been running up.
This would be on the lathe. I'm gonna turn these off for a minute. Let's try it again.
How did you get the number to lay flat as you rotated it around? You deleted the old number and replaced it.
get it to, oh, I rotated it. When I translated it, I rotated it around the side of the part instead of translating it in a rectangular fashion. I would rotate it when you're looking at the end.
Yeah, I have a bunch of zeros rotated in the right spot. Uh-huh. How do I change that number? Because when I delete it, then type in like 5, I go to click on it, puts it in a funky angle.
Take a look. You know, this rolls around a little bit when it's... when it's cutting, so that's how it should... And then again, you'd have to go in there and change your height offset on the tool. Go a little deeper. You go a little deeper.
You working off the regular one, not optional?
No, yeah, they were work the regular one, yes. The engraving portion for the optional one actually should be same. You think they're making the optional?
No.
Okay. Yeah, we're working on the regular one. So I'm going to make and at the moment, I think, I wish there was an easier way to, you know, like I say, like you asked about drawing the numbers and changing them.
What was the spacing you used on the double digit numbers? 10,
30, 10, 20, I think it was. 30, let's see.
30 thousandths?
Yeah. On the large numbers?
Yeah.
Yeah, 30 thousandths on the large numbers. Now we're going to draw the small numbers. Might go to 20 on the small numbers. I'll make a little note here about that. Number one to start with. And this to 0.02 for spacing. And I'm going to drop it right there. 0.08 is the height. So I need to drop it down. Thousands, half the height. There's our number one. So here's a couple other numbers to remember. On the big numbers, it's 72 degrees. And on the small numbers, what was it, 14.4?
So you gotta do this shit 24 times.
Yeah.
No, I'm not complaining. I'm just saying, like, that's funny. Because that's a tick of it.
Yeah, there's a lot. There are a lot of variables and processes. So I apologize. I don't have a simpler, more efficient way.
Well, it's not your fault. You think MasterCam would have something that you can...
Yeah. You know, like I was talking to Lux, there's a way of kind of laying it out in a flat pattern like this. And then you could select the flat pattern with a unroll or roll type command. And it would, and then you would set the diameter and it would roll around the part.
Kind of exactly like the print.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do that, and you roll it, and it does it.
Yeah. Yeah. So, if you discover it, then you'll have two ways of doing it. But yeah, there's lots of, you know, at least this way, you know, you can get it done. It's a little tedious. It's not very efficient. If you end up programming for a daily routine, why, you'll eventually become more and more efficient as you go. You'll learn some more stuff. This is essentially, you know, just kicking the door open and seeing what's inside it for the beginning.
Okay.
In the last, so we've got that little number here. We want to change our plane, and then I want to transform and rotate the number. Notice I check my circle thing is out here in the proper, that's where I want it. I want it to sweep around 14. Number right, 14.4 degrees. And if I turn on the level with my hash marks, you see that it, kind of hard to see, but it lines right up with this one. What we did, Jose, is we drew the outline of the part. Here, the blue wire, the outline of the part. Then we had to flip around to this orientation here to rotate this little angle piece around, and that's where these orange lines are to get the engraving lines. You have to put the change your
view.
Not only the view, but the plane. Change the plane.
But you did your first features wrong. Plane aside.
Call it. Hang on to it. If you you have this end of it finished, then what we'll need to do is build a spud, basically, that we can